Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Guider here, to No Man's Sky. You see the sky is waiting for me out there. I'm actually on a space station right now. Let's get started with a few things. First and foremost, being that this is a PC game, I don't understand what's going on with those jitters there. This is a PC game. Right off the bat, everyone needs to understand that my PC is different than your PC, which is different from the next guy's PC, which is different than the next 200,000 people's PCs. So the issues that affect me may not necessarily affect you or others. Now, we've all been watching the news, gaming news, videos, all that jazz. There are some issues with the launch of this game. There are some problems. For instance, me personally, I have to play the game borderless, windowed borderless. The reason being, if I don't, anytime I quit the game, it hard locks my PC. I have to do a full reboot every single time. I don't know why. It doesn't do that with any other games. There was just a Windows update, and maybe that has something to do with it. Could be any number of things. You never know. You really never know. Honest to God, you never know. Do some mining. Look at that. Get some sweet mining in. Some iridium. Look at that. Procedurally generated, so what I just mined out is now sitting there funky. Look at that. Sweet, sweet fractals. Alright. Yeah, there are some issues with the game, as we're all well aware. Handful of things. For instance, let me go. We're gonna name something. We're gonna name this funny little dude. But I wanna name it, it's mine. I discovered it. It's mine. It's the Guider. That's me. The Guiders. The Guider. Oh, but I can't put an apostrophe. Why? I don't understand. I don't know if it's just my keyboard or what. I can put an apostrophe in anything else. The only way, this is, honest to God, that's me pressing the apostrophe button with shift. It's a 3 for some reason. It thinks it's 3. The only way I've found to be able to do one is press the tilde next to the 1. And it puts 2 things up and I have to delete one. I don't understand. This is my bouncing buddy. That's my bouncing buddy. So I got some money for sending off for my bouncing buddy. Upload. Get those units. We name it and upload it. So you can name them whatever the hell you want. So that's an interesting, strange, I have no idea, fucking issue. There's some graphics and juddering issues. I have personally had to do this. It's borderless. Turn off VSync. As soon as I turned on VSync, it went fucking ballistic. Anti-aliasing went to this level. I'm almost positive field of view does fucking nothing. It's these two. Change these two and change the HUD. Those are the only two changes in here in this whole menu that don't require a restart of the game. And if you remember, if you have it in, or at least me, if I have it in full screen, a restart of the game, quitting to desktop actually crashes the entire fucking thing, and I have to reboot my computer. make sure to turn this up to max. I don't know why it was set at 30 by default, which is fucking stupid. Yeah, it's very, very strange. These controls are fucking weird. Flight mechanics with the mouse and keyboard, it's almost like a suggestion as opposed to actual flight mechanics. It doesn't make sense, and I'll show you when I get closer to land. Let's go explore a new planet. I think there's another planet over here. There it is. Okay, so I'm in super fast mode. You can't turn. You can't do shit. I guess it's slightly understandable. There is a fuckload. Okay, and this, when you're going really fast like this. I am trying. Look at that pop-in, too. Look at that pop-in. There is no draw distance for these random things. So I'm trying to fucking even it out and get pointed at that planet. Alright, let's go fast mode again. Let's get closer. Desperately trying to control the ship as it's going quickly. I really honest to God don't understand it. The art style is, I mean, it's pretty much what we expected from what we've seen in all of the videos, tech demos, all that jazz as the game was being built out and what you've seen elsewhere. I'm gonna run out of fucking fuel. The menus are fucking weird. The menus, I swear to God, are the same really bad menus from Destiny when it first came out. Do you remember Destiny when it first came out and the menus were just awful? And selecting items and your inventory was just god awful? That's what the menus in- holy shit, what's going on? Why am I drifting? I don't want to do this! Stop drifting up! Just want to go to the planet! Well, it looks like it's going to be full of fucking garbage. Alright, let's crash down. In fact, I say crash down, you cannot crash. I don't know if you see that, there's some frame rate jitters. Now some of these frame rate jitters, it doesn't show on as I'm playing it looks good, but on the recording it looks worse. I don't understand why. So I don't get that at all. Now that's a bit of the draw there, you see. We started in a space station, and now we've just come down to a planet. The ship, remember I said crash down? It does not want you to crash at all. I am trying to go down. You can hear my mouse. I am trying to go down. You cannot. It will slip and slide you away from the planet. I'm not going right or left. It's just doing that. It does not want you to crash. It will do everything in its power to prevent that from happening. So I'm trying to land here, right? I can't look down to where I'm going to land, so I just have to guess. Hope for the best. And that's great, because occasionally, when you do that, you kind of land on top of the buildings because you can't fucking tell. You just can't. You can't tell. There's a lot of mining, a lot of just finding all this random shit. I find these things constantly. I fuck all know of what they do. I don't have an Atlas Pass yet. I played about 4 hours, just shy of 4 hours. I've progressed mostly with the story, but I have putzed around quite a bit. So mining, if I want some iron, I want some carbon, I can look at these plants. I can analyze the plants. See, look at that. Analyze. I've now discovered all of this fun stuff. Analyze that. See? Yeah. That's the draw. That's the allure of the game, isn't it? To explore and find crazy new things like that. Look at that. Look at that funky little guy. Let's get closer. Sometimes getting these flying ones is a pain in the fucking ass. Little birdies. Analyze! Fuck it, we'll get closer. Sometimes getting them to analyze is difficult. And I may just have to fucking shoot one down. There. Can I analyze you now? That's a bat, and I can't analyze him. Look at that funky little bat guy. Please analyze! Please! What if I just wound one? Hey, you better not attack me. These weird sentinels are around. Sometimes they attack, sometimes they don't. I don't fully comprehend why or why not. Come on down. Ugh! I can't analyze them when they're dead! Let's get some plutonium. Hey, there's a guy right there! Just discovered a little fella. There's another one. Stop scanning me! I can't analyze this fucking thing! So there's a a funky little problem. I can't fucking analyze you! What if I get really close? No? Okay, I just fell. Look at that! I can't get him! What if I shoot it? Fuck's sake! Whatever! Oh, that will attack me. Yep. Bitch. So, this is some of the fun of the game. Just explore random shit. Now, there's always issues. Some shielding. Random plants give you random things. It's very strange. For what's supposed to be a devoid-ass galaxy, there is a lot of shit everywhere. Find stuff like this. Now, that's the crux of the game, isn't it, though? Is exploring? Finding cool things? Okay, new weapon upgrade that I can craft. So that's the point of the game, is explore, find cool new stuff, go nuts, all that jazz, right? But there are issues. Honest to God, I feel like the game... I feel like this game is... an early access game that's come out too early. It's charging $60, I cannot in good conscience recommend people get it now at $60. That's just me. Some of the stuff is really, like, everywhere for what is supposed to be a devoid galaxy. Oh my god. Just right off the bat, let me point out to you, if you find these things, buy them. You will run out of fucking inventory space so often, so fast, it will boggle the mind. You will not understand. So there, I found a little spot. Great, fantastic, wonderful, right? Done some exploring, got an upgrade. That's the game, right? Let's look at this inventory. That's garbage, that needs to be fixed. Crafting? Garbage, needs to be fixed. Dump some crap on the ship. Oh look, the ship doesn't have any more inventory space. Then you gotta go find places to sell things and find places to buy new things. You can buy different ships. This is actually just the beginning ship. I have not purchased a new one. It's really strange. There are some strange differences. Every time you take off, that's 25% of your fuel. And you have to refuel fucking constantly. Look at that pop-in right there. That was some sweet pop-in. You go around and you find random procedurally generated stuff like this. Let's go down. Let's land, in fact. So you need some mining? Just look around. They're fucking everywhere. Oh, there's some aluminum. Some heridium. It's literally everywhere. Absolutely everywhere. And you have to refuel everything constantly. You see here my launch thrusters. I'm gonna have to refill that. Let's put some more plutonium in there. Let's see. My life support, have to refuel that. Hazard protection, you have to refuel that. It's constantly. Your mining beam, gotta refuel that. It's a constant battle. Bolt caster, oh, I need more energy for that. Let's refuel that. Those are my bullets that I'm shooting out. Like, you have to constantly be mining. Constantly. If you don't, you run out. No ifs, ands, or buts. You will run out. I have been almost stuck places before, like on a space station. I had to refuel stuff. It's weird. Like, I wasn't actually stuck once I figured out what I needed to do, but I had no idea. There is very little in the way of... There's no hand-holding, which, in and of itself, not a bad thing. You don't need your hand held constantly, but I would like some idea of what the fuck I'm supposed to do. All you get is those tooltips in the bottom right, and it does not help. It does not show you. It just tells you what your next quest objective is. It does not tell you. Oh, great. A short burst adapter, so another upgrade for my gun. You just run around and find stuff like that. Some carbon. It's the strangest shit. With this, I need a bypass chip, so that means I need to craft one. So I go here, crafting, go to E, bypass chip. Everything you do in the menu is a long press. You don't just click it. You just click it, it pulls up this stuff. Now I can't, I can hover over this, but I can't go look, I can't look at these things. In the menus, you have to long press everything. I don't understand why. I have to hold E, I can't just... It's a long press, I don't know why. Feel like that's because this was originally all on the PS4. It's for a controller. It's not for mouse and keyboard, and they haven't really gotten any better with it. Another fun thing, this is on the plus side, searching for alien artifacts. There's all this, like, lore. Okay, that was some screen shatter. There's all this lore and all this, like, background stuff and information just around, just out and about, and I love that. That's the type of stuff that drew me to the game, is finding, just going out and exploring, finding all kinds of crazy stuff. Although it still is fairly confusing to me. After, what, 4 hours that I've played now? Still somewhat confusing? We'll hit this up real quick and then we'll go to the monolith. I'll show you what the monoliths are all about. Space controls. Oh, look. Does this look familiar to anyone? This look familiar? Fucking Wheatley. Just a random trade network. And it's legit Wheatley. Sell some stuff, make some money. You have to sell constantly because you run out of inventory space. Constantly. And my ship, I didn't land it very close, so I can't sell from the ship inventory. I can only sell from this inventory. And if I want to sell from that, I actually have to pull it to my inventory, because I'm close enough for that. I'm close enough to pull from my ship inventory to my current inventory, my exosuit, but not close enough for this to recognize that it's there. I don't understand. But sometimes, if your ship is close enough, it will be an option there to sell from inventory. For the life of me, I cannot figure it out. Cannot. There's Wheatley. I don't have my Atlas Pass yet, so I can't do anything with these. The Atlas Pass is, as you progress through the story, there's two different routes you can go, as far as I can tell. And, you get the Atlas Pass and it'll unlock stuff. Spaceships, or not spaceships, but space stations have, like, doors that you can unlock. Those things that you can pick up on the ground, you can unlock. The controls, oh my god, look, it does not want me to crash. It's pushing me. I'm trying. Here's a fun part. Let's see, the monolith is on the other side of this mountain. So I might not see it. Oh, there's another upgrade there that I should come back to. Oh, thank god, the monolith is, oh, okay. I can't see where the monolith is. I can't go down. I can't look down. Oh, please. Please let me see where the monolith is. I can't. Okay, so I'm just gonna have to guess. 4, 3, 2, 1, land. Please be close to the monolith. Not close to the monolith. Fuck! God! So my best bet is to just get where I can jump jet up there. My jetpack. Because I couldn't fucking see where I was gonna land. No way to tell. Ugh. So that right there is a small complaint, but it's a complaint nonetheless. And it, again, is one of those things that makes me feel like this is an early access game that should be 20, 30, 40 bucks, maybe. Has fun stuff like this, though, where I'm discovering ancient languages. As I discover these things, it actually does change things. So if I go out and speak to an alien and I want to sell stuff to them, or maybe something like, as you'll see in just a moment, this, it will have a thing on the bottom left where it will show what the thing is saying to me. It'll have a little text box, what this thing is saying to me. And as I've discovered more of the language, like that, I start to understand. So it translates. Now, I don't have much of the language right now. And what does this mean? It means I only know Toilgek and First Spawn. I don't know what the rest of this shit says. I hear a low rumble, which gradually builds into an ancient scream. It's like no other noise I've ever experienced. To the strange alien landscape, it's a calm silence. Inside my helmet, it's a nightmarish cacophony of pain and death. Through the noise, however, I make out some words within the screens. So, now I have an option. It will give you a bad, where nothing happens. You don't get anything from it. It'll give you a good, where your influence with the Gek increases. It'll give you a really good, where it gives you stuff. But because I have no idea what this stuff is, it's a guessing game. Your guess is as good as mine. Let's touch the monolith. Fuck it. Let's see what happens. The vengeful spirits that inhabit this place are grateful for my obedience. So I guessed right. Without having learned more of the knowledge. Okay, I guessed wrong. They fucking hurt me. I thought I guessed right. See? It said they're glad for my obedience, but I guessed wrong. What the fuck? I don't understand. I guessed wrong then. You can't do it again. So, without having any knowledge of what the fucking language was, it's a guessing game. Your guess is as good as mine. And I guessed wrong. So, I was punished there. My standing with the Gek has decreased, and I took damage. If I had guessed correctly, well then, I might have gotten something out of it. But I didn't. Fuck! Remember what I said about refueling? There we go. Constantly refueling. And there goes another 25%. Oh my god! It's the strangest. It's truly a strange combination of good, bad, and ugly. At this point in time, I cannot, in good conscience, recommend this game for $60. I just cannot. There's so many strange, interesting, wild things to find, and there is quite a good deal of variation. And if you want to just plop down and go exploring for hours, this is a good option. However, there are quite a few other games that you can find. Pull up Steam, take a look-see. It's not an unheard of genre. It's just an underrepresented genre. For me, that's a shame. I wish there was more space exploration. I wish there was more space exploration. I wish it was done well. I've put so many hours into games like this. Oh my god, thank yes. More upgrades. I need the inventory space. I honestly feel like, and I will say this again and again and again, this is an early access game that is charging too much for what it is at this point in time. Now, it does appear that they are going to be all about continuing with the updates, continuing with the patches, adding new stuff to the game. So that's all well and good, and hopefully in a month or two time, the game becomes just that much better and is at that point where I would be more comfortable recommending it to a broader audience. Now, if you're like me, I can deal with it right now. I don't have the massive frame judders. I'm not sure how it's coming across. To be perfectly honest with you, I'm not sure how it's coming across in the video. I've tested it, and it came across fairly well. There were some judders that I did not see while playing, but I did see in the video. And then it did sometimes accurately represent some of the screen judders that I was seeing while playing in the video. But for the most part, after I got past figuring out that it needs to be in borderless windowed mode, and going from there, I can play the game without it chugging along. Now, again, as I said at the beginning of the video, my computer is different than your computer, is different from the next person's computer, is different, so on and so forth. What I'm finding and dealing with is not going to be the same as what you're finding and dealing with. At this point in time, I can play the game without it driving me fucking nuts. Just ballistic. I can't imagine playing it when it's sitting at 30 frames per second, which it was at first. And it was awful. Just plain awful. Oh, what are you doing, buddy? What are you? Look at that! Can I feed him? Look at this guy! Hey, buddy! Do I have what I need to feed you? Let's give him some iron. Yeah! Now he's my buddy! Look at you! You're a pretty little funky, weird goat demon thing. But now he likes me because I fed him some iron. Why the fuck would he eat iron? I don't understand! I'll restore the shield. I don't think my shield is down. Whatever. What do you need, buddy? What's up? Want some? Oh, he brought me some food! Look at that, he brought me that. When you make friends with them, they bring you stuff. And then you use that to craft. Oh, I like your tails. You also kind of look like you have the spotting of a giraffe. Cool looking motherfucker. Hey, look at that, what are you? I've already discovered you. You look like an armadillo. Let's give you some heridium. And you like me now too. So there are fun things to find. Oh, it's a baby! It's a baby! Baby! Hey, little buddy. Do I have iron? I don't think I have any iron for him. Oh, it's a baby! Get some iron. I need to feed the baby! Where'd the baby go? Baby. Little buddy. There you go, little buddy! It's so interesting, the things that happen and things that you can do in the game. It really is. I love it. I love that aspect of it. Exploring, finding these crazy little things that look like they come straight out of the good parts of Spore. So that's why the game draws me, and I think why it draws so many of you out there in. It's such an underrepresented good portion of the genre. There is some stuff out there that's like this, but man, do I really wish they would do it well. Let me know what you think down below. You play it? Have you got it? You got your gaming fix in? Have you done any of this? What do you think is the good, the bad, and the ugly? Now, granted, I have my own opinions, but yours may differ, and again, yours may differ because your experience with the game has been different than mine. I feel like I'm a little bit lucky in that I've gotten it to work, and I've gotten it to work fairly well, fairly stable. I don't have the best computer out there, but I've got a pretty good computer. My components are good. So there's that. But anyways, I've been DeGuider. This is No Man's Sky. I think I'm going to keep up with the game. I think I'm going to keep playing. I'm going to keep updating as it updates. Cool. Just random generated crap that just looks so cool. And there's little babies running around. Look at the little guys. I'm going to feed you. Come here. Do I have anything to feed him with? Anyways, this has been No Man's Sky. The good, the bad, the ugly. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. We'll see you next time.